Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. He's a world-renowned bassist who rose to fame as one of the original members of Prince's legendary group, The Revolution, honey.
Yes, but music's still an integral part of his life. He continues to tour and create new tunes. Please welcome Brown Mars.
Yay!
Thank you.
Prince and The Revolution.
My
God, today and tomorrow.
I know.
Now, Mark, did music find you, or did you find music?
Wow. It found me. It found me in front of a television set when I was about 6 years old.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Watching the Jackson 5.
Mm. And then you were just captivated.
That was it, yeah. I was hooked from that point forward, you know.
Yeah.
You know, you believe in a really, really lost feeling in the industry because you believe in musicianship and instrumentation.
Yeah.
Everyone doesn't believe in that anymore.
Yeah. Yeah.
Why do you think that has such an impact on your craft?
Because it comes from a different place, you know, inside. When you grow up in it, it's not just about the playing the music, your entire environment. And I can relate to hip hop, too, because it's the same thing, only the difference is we play instruments where, you know, they rap about the streets. Well, we play about our environment, the feeling of the music that comes out of us. It's all about the environment we grew up around. Mm-hmm. And that's why the Minneapolis sound was so unique at the time, because Prince and I, we grew up in the very same environment, very racially charged. It's a subtle racism, but it was there. And then you grow up in that, and then you don't have black radio stations, so all you're doing is listening to rock and country, and then here you have this sound that starts to develop from it. And,
That's interesting that you say that, because when you listen to Prince's music, you hear all of these different elements in his music.
Absolutely.
He went from such a wide range. Mm-hmm. What was it like? I mean, I know you said you grew up in the same area with him, but what was it like playing or accompanying a musician who could literally play every single instrument?
Right.
What is that like? I mean, that's gotta be tough. Like, if you play an A sharp, okay then, and he's like, no man, this is D, you know.
Yeah, you can't escape.
So what is it like playing for a musician like Prince?
The funny thing is, I think most of us from Minnesota can play it all. We all, I mean, and again, it's that environment we grew up. I mean, I started on drums and went to bass, guitar, keyboards, and we're all like that.
Mm.
The difference between most of us and Prince, he wasn't from this planet.
I mean,
this guy was phenomenal. There's a genius, but then there's a musical genius, and he was one of the greatest. And I played with a lot of them.
Yeah. All the time.
But this guy, you know, there is no comparison to what
was so special. Like, what made him that step above from what you were able to see with your own eyes?
I don't know.
He just has it.
Well, he lived and breathed it. I remember I used to laugh at him and say, "Did you sleep in that last night?" You know, because he'd come in and he'd be all decked out. But I think he lived and breathed what he did.
Mm-hmm. What did he bring out of you? I mean, you all said you guys kind of did all of this together and could play anything, but as a musician, what was he able to bring out of you?
The work ethic.
Mm-hmm.
That's the most important thing, you know. Even today, I try to, with a lot of youth, I try to give them, you know, inspiration and help them and guide them in their path. But they lack that work ethic. Nowadays, they don't have the work ethic that we grew up in. Because, I mean, we spent hours.
That's across the board.
Yeah. We spent hours in a day. I mean, I used to carry my guitar on my back, and I'd be in class at school with a guitar on my back.
Mm-hmm.
And walking down the hall, everybody knew, oh, that's a guitar player.
Yeah.
And that's how we lived back then.
Yeah.
So out loud, almost.
Yeah.
What was the most impactful moment you spent with Prince?
Oh, wow, there was many. I can't say there was one most.
Mm-hmm.
But I would say the first show after the Rolling Stones show. Rolling Stones was my first show, started in a stadium. My last show ended in a stadium. I had left the Revolution and our last show was at the Yokohama Stadium. And the cool thing is that, you know, I wrote this book because that inspiration that I experienced from that time to the end was phenomenal. I mean, the things that I went through, I mean, against all odds, I made it over mountains of obstacles,
yeah.
You know, yeah. And so, yeah, I think it's the two stadium shows that were the most influential in my whole life, the turning point in my life with Prince.
After we lost Prince, you and the Revolution decided to get together and you all toured and did a series of concerts in his honor. What was that like for you emotionally and mentally?
It was hard. We even called the first tour, we called it a healing tour.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and that's what we labeled it as, because the fans, you know, they needed a healing, but we did more than anybody.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, a lot of people don't realize we spent an average of 12 to 15 hours a day, you know,
together.
Not a week, a day with this guy.
Mm-hmm.
And all throughout our careers after Prince, you know, after we left the Revolution, we still all stayed in touch.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So for him to all of a sudden one day I get that phone call, I mean that tore me up.
Yeah. So many people.
Oh my God.
Yes.
Yeah. How can you honor him in your new projects? Talk to us about your new projects and everything that you have going that is still gonna sustain Prince and keep his legacy alive.
Yeah. It's the approach to the music. It's all about the music. It's all about the feeling of the music. And like what Prince did, the music has to say something. You know, I don't know what I can say on the air, but
right.
You know, it's not about bees and hoes.
Okay.
You know,
right.
it's about music with substance and that people can listen to and enjoy. And it has no time stamp on it.
Yeah.
Because the stuff that I'm trying to write 25 years from now, you're going to be like, oh yeah, I like that song. Mm-hmm. I remember that.
Right.
You know, and that's what Prince was like.
Yes.
You know?
Yes. Absolutely.
Yes.
Absolutely.
My God.
That's wonderful. We thank
My
you so
favorite.
Much.
Thank you so much
for being here joining us today.
Woo-hoo.
You can keep up with Brown Mark's tour dates and new music by following him on Instagram @BrownMarkPrince Revolution on Instagram. Up next.